Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing your work very well. So today I will discuss the chapter safety and first aid, which is also there in your second term. So let's start the chapter. Accidents. So what is accidents? Accidents can happen anytime. Accident can be happen anytime, anywhere, and without any warning. So before accident may happen, it doesn't give us any warning or it doesn't give any signals that now you will have to face an accident. So people may get hurt in accidents, and we may get hurt in accidents. Sometimes the accident may be more dangerous and would lead to death. Sometimes accident may be very dangerous and it leads to death also. So accidents usually happen when someone is careless. So when accidents happen, when someone is careless, accidents happen. So let us see some common reasons for accidents. So now we will read some common reasons which may cause accident and what we should do to avoid them and how should we avoid those accidents. First one is sharp objects. Accidents can happen when you are careless while using sharp objects such as knives or scissors. You can see in the picture boy is cutting and carrot. So when accidents happen by using sharp objects, when we are carelessly use the sharp objects, for example knives or scissors, learn to use them correctly. So we should learn how to use these sharp objects and use them only in the presence of an adult. And when will you use these sharp objects? When we are with your adult. Knives and scissors are not toys. They are not toys, means they cause accidents. So they are not things which we should play with them. Next is electricity. So electricity is very useful, but it needs careful handling. Okay, electricity is very useful, you know very well, but we need to be careful while handling this electricity board. Playing with electrical points and electrical appliances at home is a common cause of accidents. So you can see in the picture, this picture, okay. So playing with electrical points, you shouldn't play with the electrical points and electrical appliances at home is a common cause of, it may cause a dangerous accidents. Electric shocks are very dangerous and may even lead to death. Electric shocker, you know, electric shocker very dangerous and it may even lead to death. Do not play with electrical equipment. Okay. Next is fire. So similarly, playing with matchsticks or firecrackers or being careless while using them can cause, next page, dangerous fires. Okay. So fire, similarly playing with matchstick, we shouldn't play with the matchstick or firecrackers or being careless while using them can cause, it can also cause in fire, dangerous fires. Many accidents happen when people are careless with firecrackers. You can see in this picture they are light firecrackers only in the presence of an adult. So when should we light the firecrackers? When you are with an adult during festivals such as Diwali. So always be careful when lighting firecrackers and do not play with matchsticks. Okay. Next is on the road. So accidents happen when people drive or walk carelessly on the road. So you can see in this picture, cross the road only at a zebra crossing and with an adult. So you should cross the road when at a zebra crossing and with an adult. Okay. And be careful when you are crossing the road and do not follow when you shouldn't follow the traffic rules, accidents may happen. Sometimes children place on the road or run across roads to cross them. Sometimes what happened, children play on the roads and cross the roads without any maintaining the rules. So this is very dangerous. Never play on or near a road. So never play in the road or near the road. Always cross a road only at a zebra crossing. So always cross the road at a zebra crossing. You can see in this picture. Okay, these white things are called zebra crossing. Next is at home or in school. So climbing on furniture, running up and down stairs and climbing trees are common cause of a accident with children. So climbing on furniture, running up down stairs, climbing trees are the common causes of accidents for children. So running or pushing others on the stairs can cause accident. So we shouldn't push when someone is walking on the stairs. So we shouldn't push that person. Do not climb on furniture in the classroom or while playing at home. Climb stairs in a line and always be careful while climbing trees. So when you are climbing in the stairs, you should be in a line and you should be very careful while climbing trees. Next is medicines. Sometimes children eat or drink harmful substances like cleaning liquids or wrong medicines. Sometimes what happens? Children eat wrong medicines. Okay, this can be very dangerous. So it can be a very dangerous for children. Never eat or drink anything you are not sure of. So never eat or drink that medicine you are not sure. You should consult your adult or your parent. Okay, at home medicine should be kept out of reach of small children. So in home you should keep the medicine out of reach of the small children. Next is swimming. So drowning means what? Dying because of being immersed in water can occur in pool and ponds. Always swim in presence of an adult who knows swimming. So when you are in a pool, you are going to swim, you should tell your adult to stand with you and see whether you are able to swim or not. If you do not know swimming, do not go to the deep end. So if you don't know how to swim, please do not go to the deep end. Okay, next page is first aid. So what is first aid? Accidents can happen no matter how careful you are. Accidents can be happen anytime, anywhere, even you are very careful. Many people do not know what to do when there is an accident or an injury. So many people become nervous. They didn't know how to overcome that accident or injury. Okay, you should know what help should be given to an injured person. So you should know what treatment you should give to an injured person. So the immediate help given to an injured or sick person is called first aid. You can underline these lines. The main aims of first aid. So there are some aims to use the first aid. First is to save lives, to make sure the condition of the injured or sick person doesn't become worse, and to keep the injured or sick person comfortable till proper medical help arrives. Okay, these are the aims of using first aid. It is very important for you to know what to do when an accident occurs. You should know about first aid and also when to give first aid and when not to. Okay, so you should, before you use first aid, you should know when to give first aid and when we shouldn't give the first aid. You should give first aid only if the injury is small. So you should give first aid when only the injury, when the injury is small. For example, a small burn or a small scratch. Even then, call an adult for help. If the injury looks serious, for example, if the injury is inside the body and the injured person is in great pain, there may be broken bones or internal bleeding. So if the injury is inside your body and the injured person is getting very great pain, and in that may be cause of an broken bones or internal bleeding, you shouldn't give that first aid. In such a situation, do not try to give first aid yourself. Immediately call an adult for help. Okay, so that's for this video. In our next video, we will continue this chapter. Okay, I hope you understood up to that. Okay, thank you, students.